Right, so good afternoon. So just now Dr. Norman already mentioned a little bit about how we teach the first year programming. I'm just going to show you some of the things that we are working on so that computing is exciting for SUTD students. So as you know that SUTD, all students, they have to learn computing, either they go to architecture or engineering system. I think we really want every student to learn computing. And this is one of the paper by Alan Bundy, and he speaks about that computing is pervasive in research also. It means that computational thinking is actually affecting not just IT and computers, but it's also affecting how other research fields actually doing their research, how they actually think, how they ask questions and all these kind of things. But the question is, are our students able to see this? Right? Are our students able to see that computing is actually pervasive, or they just see computing as just a tool? This is the MOE syllabus, the O-level. And sometimes when we talk that computing is everywhere, we tend to think that they are on the use of the application, which is on the top right over there. But what we want to bring about is actually the computational thinking part is also pervasive in all other subjects and disciplines as well. Right? So that's the idea that we want. And I think this is something that we want to talk about when we talk about intrinsic motivation. If they see something that's applicable to the, what they like and what this day-to-day that they see, maybe they will find that computing is interesting. Just now I was just talking with Dr. Melvin. He's talking about LED lights and all this kind of thing. And this is one way that we want to bring computing to be interesting, because it is what they see in their real life. Right? It's not just something in their computers. So one way that SUTD does it is that we have what we call as a 2D integrated design net. So in SUTD, we have what we call as the 1D design, 2D design, 3D design, and 4D design. The 1D design is the little dots that the students has to do in one subject. These are like the mini projects that is particularly for that one subject. And I think most of the courses and most of the schools have this. But in 2D, what we do is that we have a common project that is cross subjects, right? And the assessment is also cross subjects. So in the sense that when we have a computing assignment with physics, so both is 10% of computing assignment, 10% of physics assignment. I'm going to tell you a little bit some of these project assignments. But we find that this is one way that we are trying to bring computing to be everywhere, and so that the student can see that computing is actually everywhere. Now, one of the assignments that we design is between digital world and physical chemistry, and we design this for 6 weeks. So in the first 6 weeks, just now Dr. Norman mentioned that they learn about concepts of programming. So in every week, we give them one task that at the end of 6 weeks, they'll be able to visualize the distribution of hydrogen atom, the electron in hydrogen atom. Right? So we align the conditionals so that they choose certain polynomials in their Lagrange. They have to calculate mathematical functions. They have to create the grids using iterations and all these kind of things. And then they learn also about factorization, so that at the end, they will see what they learn in chemistry. They learn about orbitals and all this kind of thing. But they learn the maths, they learn how to code it. They understand better on how things are working. And we align it with our learning objectives. So that every week, when we talk about conditionals, there will be a part that they have to apply conditionals to arrive at these big problems. When we talk about iterations, there will be a part that they have to do iterations, doing some algorithms, so that at the end they get the final calculations for this one. Now, this is another project that they are doing. This is a 2D project between digital world and physical world, which is a physics subject. So if you remember your alcohol thermometer, it takes quite a long time for it to be stable, because it takes some time for temperature to reach thermal equilibrium. But the digital thermometer is pretty fast. So we show students how it actually works if they can learn about regressions and some techniques in machine learning. What they do is that with the initial data that they have in the first few seconds, they have to be able to predict the final temperature. So the students design some experiment. They create the incubator. They design, they model in physics, because this is part of the physics, on the heat transfer equations. And then they take real data experiments, they take measurements, they model it. And what is interesting is that once they know the model, not just the numbers, they actually can predict it better, because they can extract better features in machine learning. So in data analytics, one of the things that they need to know is understanding the data. And this is where if they know the physics better, actually they can perform better in these assignments. This is another design project with biology. So they learn DNA in their biology in that term, in the same term. And what they are asked is to calculate costs when they are designing a primer in DNA. Right, so they have to find a forward primer and a reverse primer. And in fact, they are exposed to probabilistic algorithm, which is simulated annealing. So this is a first year programming, but they encounter this probabilistic algorithm when they want to find this optimization. How do you find the best primer in a long string of DNA? So this has become like a string problem. You can simplify to a search string algorithm. But the one that we are proposing is actually a probabilistic algorithm. Now, this is another design challenge. This is for the second year for ISTD pillar. ISTD is the computing pillar in SUTD. And so what we have here is a 2D design challenge for three subjects. 5001 is another programming, introduction to information system and programming. They learn Java as a programming language, but some other programming concept. 5002 is on computation structures, so starting from transistor to operating system. 5004 is on algorithms. Right, so in this design challenge, they take all these subjects in the same term, so they have to optimize the arithmetic logic unit part, which is the 32-bit adder, and they design it. They design the circuits, so this part of the architecture part, and they have to optimize it from 14 nanosecond to 3 nanosecond so that it works with higher frequencies. And once they optimize it, they have their previous design, and we show them how they can, well, actually this is part of the thing that they have to do. They have to create a software using their what they learned in 5001, satisfiability. So the problem can be reduced to satisfiability problem. So this is what we call as the checking equivalent circuit. Right. So, and I think for those of you who are in computer science, you know that certain problems can be reduced to another problem that you know already how to solve the solutions. So this is one way that we are doing it. It's actually formal checking. You can check the whole circuit without testing the individual input one by one, whether the two circuits are the same and whether they are equivalent using satisfiability. And then for the algorithm part, they actually analyze the performance of a two-set algorithm. So they talk about different complexity, which one is more efficient, and they have to show that if it is a two-set problem, it is actually polynomial. So in fact, for the what we are trying to say is that even for the same degree, we are trying to do the 2D design challenge, because this is where we help the student to see the connections between the different subjects. They are not isolated. They have one big picture, and they are actually interconnected. And I'd like to end with this one. This is by Margaret Whitley in Leadership and the New Science. So, you know, when you talk about computing, we always talk about modularizations and abstractions. These are important, and sometimes we forget that the interface is also important. Right? And if we believe that the computational thinking is everywhere, and maybe we should think about how this computational thinking will interface with other subjects and other disciplines. And I really like what Prof. Leong just now mentioned. He tried to push computational thinking to everyone. I think the schools will have this advantage because you are more closer with other subjects, with other teachers. Some of you already have the previous background from other disciplines. Right? And we have to help the students to see that computational thinking is actually everywhere, because this is where the innovations will be. Thank you.